Hello, it's now 8:30. Do you know what channel this is? This is Public Access, and you're watching a Paper Tiger presentation of TV Turn On, a TV show about public access, fighting for public access TV, tuning into the community. Knock it out. Once upon a time, not long ago, about 20 years or so. ABC, NBC, CBS, and PBS ruled the airwaves. But they didn't always say the things that people felt. TV was boring and people were snoring. There was no way of the fact to be ignoring that we needed our own voice. Dun, 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 dun. But one day, the streets were wild with change. And things were soon to be arranged. Bum 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 tiki 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 ba ba dum tiki 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 tiki. Along came cable, dap dap, and it made people able, dap ba da ba da, to make their own things, that is their own voices, to be brought across the TV, to you the audience, and you the audience were able to do the same, because we're a community and it's available to you and me. That's right, cable TV. Knock it out.
We are all dominated by electronic media. For the most part, it's a one-way process. But it shouldn't be a one-way process any more than any means of communication should be one-way. So what we're trying to do in Access is to give millions of ordinary people the right to use this vehicle to speak with each other and to speak with the public officials.
Public Access came into existence roughly 20 years ago when the cable companies used public streets to run their cable for private profit. Because of this, they had to give something back to the city. People saw this as an opportunity to have access to the electronic media, and cities required cable companies to provide free access TV in exchange for the use of public land. In the 1970s, people in New York City organized around the cable franchise and got two public access channels for Manhattan, over which the cable companies had no editorial control. Since that time, many communities across the country have mobilized and acquired not only channels, but studios, production equipment, and training. Manhattan is one of the largest information capitals in the world, and ironically, it has one of the worst access resources in the country. In 1989, NYCRM, a volunteer group of media activists, producers, and community members, got together to get real access TV on cable in New York City. NYCRM worked in research and policy to find out what other places had in terms of access and put together a proposal to the city. NYCRM organized workshops to educate and encourage communities to participate in the renewal process. They demand Time Warner provide free studio facilities, equipment, training, and more channel capacity.
The franchise that as it now exists says that there's supposed to be local injection points in all 12 of the school districts. And we should really push for that. We should push not just for one, but many flowers blooming, many public access centers. And this is probably the most lucrative franchise in the entire United States. Manhattan Cable gets so much profits out of this one franchise that we should really, this is an incredible group. I'm really really amazed that so many people came together, but I hope we can get some organizing, kind of ongoing organizing of the people who are here, because we should demand that Manhattan Cable and whatever form it takes, Warner, Paramount, whatever, share that profit that they get from this community.
We're here to ask, not to ask, but to demand what is naturally our right, access to media, access to video equipment, access to audio equipment, studios that we can use, and upkeep of facilities. We're here to demand that from Manhattan Cable that is already provided in other cities all over the country.
Hi, this is Frank Davis at Community Television. Here we're giving a tour of the events of what goes on here. Okay, now let's head over to this direction where we'll see an individual here doing some viewing of his tapes and possibly, yeah, logging in. Yeah, here we go. And your name is?
Sylvester Washington.
Yeah, Sylvester Washington, yes. He's working on one of your projects, right? Yes, and this one pertains to?
Daycare centers. Specifically church daycare centers.
If there wasn't a place like this Access Center, do you think you would be working on this kind of a project?
Definitely not, because it's something that I would never be able to afford, and it have helped me to increase my technical knowledge and understanding of this type of communication.
This is the equipment room here. This is racks and racks of equipment that you can see maybe through here. Here's a deck, couple decks still left here. And I don't know what that is. Oh, monitors, I guess. Over here, this is the tape library, which I should move out of the way here. You can see the tape library. These are, I believe, things that were produced on Staten Island. Over here, we have the video, a monitor, then the whatever this, the wave screen, whatever this is down here. Down here we have a beta and a VHS. This is for bumping up. Anyway, this all around you here is the rest of the equipment room.
These are broadcast decks, so the quality is really good, and you can roll in 3/4 and record onto 3/4. And that's basically what we've got here. We can run slides, a slide machine that can run right into video right here, a still store so you can catch still frames off of video. It's just about endless.
At my school, they never really told us anything about access, but I had a friend and she heard about CTV, and then she told me about it, and I couldn't believe it, so I had to come see for myself. And it was true.
Are you a believer now?
I'm a believer.
Thank you.
We have the Charters TV project there, and one of the biggest cultural facilities in the Lower East Side that we start trying to restore. One of the things that we want to do inside that cultural facility is to provide a studio where, you know, the common people, the poor, the minority, and anybody that wants to produce at the TV projects could produce them there. Media communication is growing, and the minorities have to start getting jobs and training in the artistic and technical aspect of that.
I'm Jocelyn Taylor. I'm a member of DIVA, and that's Damned Interfering Video Activists. We're an affinity group of ACT UP, the AIDS Coalition to Unleash Power. DIVA is committed to making media which directly counters and interferes with dominant media assumptions about AIDS and governmental negligence in dealing with the AIDS crisis. We are committed to challenging a sexist, racist, and heterosexist dominant media, which is complicit with our repressive government. DIVA is a nonprofit group of non-salaried people with varying video experience. We urge the city to negotiate responsibly so that some of the millions of dollars profiteered by cable franchises will be returned to the community so that people can empower themselves and give testimony to their own experiences within their own neighborhoods in regards to the AIDS crisis.
Why we're here in front of Time Warner to try and get a public access studio. You know, why are we here? That's because Time Warner is the company that holds the contract to cable in New York City right now. And its contract is in renegotiation. After 20 years, they have to renegotiate to get a new contract with the city of New York. And the offering that they have made to the city has incredibly inadequate provisions, not only for access, but for many other things. And in fact, the city is not too happy about it and will be deciding by, I believe it's May 15th, whether or not they are going to continue to negotiate with Time Warner. Of course, if they decide not to negotiate with the incumbent company, it means a lot of hassles, because this company is here, it's entrenched, it's made a lot of investments in infrastructure, and everybody would like to see it work with that company. But, you know, they've got to make good franchise provisions that have been in the franchise for 20 years that they've never made good. And what we're talking about, what could actually end up funding access, is an incredibly small percentage of the franchise fee that they pay to the city of New York.
What do we want? Access! When do we want it? Now! What do we want? Access! When do we want it? Now!
I'm sure many of you saw last week that 100,000 people from the Haitian community gathered downtown to protest discriminatory policy regarding donation of blood. Those people found out about that demonstration from cable television, and they found out about that demonstration through UHF channels. So cable and UHF are ways that we can mobilize our communities to get out and to stand up for our rights. Mainstream television has constantly erased us, constantly understressed the importance that we play in this city. Access to facilities is a way that we can reach out to others, and we must continue to put pressure on Time Warner. No contract, no access, no contract.
The Educational Video Center is a program that works with young people throughout the city, giving them equipment and training to do documentaries about the issues and concerns that they have. And the ironic thing is that they've been recognized and supported all around the country, and in fact, by organizations internationally, but they're not really being heard here in New York City. So what I want to do is urge Time Warner to really make public access accessible to the public. And not to turn its back on the young people of our city or the other community groups who are really not heard on commercial network TV. Their voices are not heard, their visions are not seen. But we know that they have compelling, important stories to tell, and the issues that they're talking about are issues that are concerned to all of us, such as the homelessness problem, the racism that's all around our city and nationally. These are issues that really have to get out there, and we're asking that Time Warner make sure that the Manhattan Cable TV gives resources, equipment, facility, and active support for the young people, for teachers, for other community groups around our city, and open this up so that we really have public access available to everyone.
No access, no contract! No access, no contract! No access, no contract! No access, no contract! No access, no contract!
Can you believe it? Staten Island has access and New York City does not. All we have is channels. Public access, the concept of public access, is access to the means of production of imagery, access to equipment, access to training, access to publicity in the newspaper. Do you realize the newspaper, and this is not a coincidence, I think there's a reason for it, refuses to run in the television listings what's going on the access channel. And that's a non-commercial listing. People do not pay to have CNN listed, CBS, NBC, ABC. They don't want people, regular people, to make media, because maybe it will sound different than what the mainstream media is putting out. And there's nothing more powerful in for people learning than to see contradictions, right? One person says yes, another person says no. Maybe the truth is a bit more complicated. That's what public access is all about. It's about everybody being able to appreciate that life is a bit more complicated, right? And that you're going to have to struggle and really think through.
And also, Access is about having fun. It's about children making media. It's about disabled people making media. It's about deaf people making media. It's about blind people are producing public access television in many communities.
If you look way up here to the top of the Time Life building, you'll recognize you're standing at the center of the communication capital of the world. And if we think about that for a moment and we begin to wonder whether or not the monopolization of the media is an abridgment of our First Amendment rights, our rights to express ourselves and our rights to be ourselves, then you do have a question to ponder, and perhaps you want to think a little bit more about public access television and what that means. Thank you.
This is not the Twilight Zone or the Outer Limits. This is New York City, Manhattan today. We have a big problem. We're losing our free speech, the First Amendment rights. We need public access that's really accessible to the independent producers so that we can bring across important issues. Gay issues, art programs, creative, independent producers are trying to bring this beautiful stuff to you, and Time Warner doesn't care about anything but making money. Do not attempt to adjust your TV set or change the channel. Just pay attention to what's going down here today. Now is the time to do something about it, because the franchise is expiring, and unless the people of New York City demand better public access, more responsive to the community needs, we're going to lose it. We're not taking advantage of the beautiful opportunity we have now to bring real freedom of speech, freedom of expression to the people of New York City. Force Time and Warner to comply with their contract to provide accessible, real facilities to the public access producers so that they can give you the important programming that you deserve.
Monday, April 2nd, was AIDS Awareness Day on PBS. Peter Jennings, in his wonderful AIDS Quarterly, talked about the lack of safe sex education in the country. That same night, my viewers were not allowed to see my safe sex show because you, Dick, ordered Manhattan cable technicians not to play it. My show, targeted to a gay audience, encourages vigilance and safe sex practices. By squelching my explicit and informative communication, you have attacked all the gay men of Manhattan.
Okay, folks, without public access, you're not getting the whole story. You're not even getting half of the story. You're getting the biased opinion of a small fraction of our society. Okay? We demand that Time Warner give monies back to the community so that all voices can be heard from all sides. Okay? Yeah. Keep access TV censorship free. Keep access TV censorship free. Keep access TV censorship free.
Excuse me?
What are you doing out here today?
A little close, aren't you?
What are you doing out here?
I'm leafleting people. I'm leafleting people so they find out more about public access television.
All right, get them to do it.
Here, you want to get a shot of my flyer?
Yeah, I'm just your regular video camera, and I'm really sick and tired of shooting all
the shots talking
about it. I want some money.
In one place, it's the major medium, and it's really important that everybody have a voice, or that there at least be a place where if you want you can have a voice and you don't have to pay a lot of money.
No access, no contract. No access, no contract.
Right now, Time Warner, in the form of Manhattan Cable and Paragon, is negotiating with the city of New York for a renewal of their cable franchise agreements, okay? For the last 20 years, we've been locked into inadequate public access provisions in that contract. We have nothing more than channel capacity. If you are a local producer and you want to produce a show for public access, on which you can run no advertising and generate no revenue, you have to pay hundreds of dollars to go to a private studio or to rent equipment and editing facilities. This is an abridgment of our First Amendment rights to free speech. Plain and simple, right?
Right.
So, if we don't get more facilities, studio facilities in various neighborhoods around the city, portable equipment, editing facilities, administrative personnel, and more channel capacity to broadcast the programs that we create, we are urging the Board of Estimate on May 15th this year to vote no. Do not renew these cable franchise agreements. No access, no contract. No access, no contract. No access, no contract.
Hi, my name's Fiona, and I'm a part of Paper Tiger Television. We've been struggling for a decade making television shows on public access that look at the information industry, and I'd like to say that we've been watching Time for a long time, and we're sick and tired of having to make cardboard cameras and cardboard microphones. We want real cameras, and we want them now, or we're gonna raise hell.
Why does a city like New York City have to be behind other cities like Staten Island, like Somerville, Massachusetts, like Austin, Texas? It's time. It's time overdue that New York City catches up with the rest of the country and gets free access, better service.
Access, no contract. No access, no contract.
Say, another metaphor that's been used to try to describe access to people is to describe the airwaves, quite literally, like the waterways and you know, the land. The airwaves are really a public trust, and that if you could think of access as sort of the public parks of the airwaves, and they have to be tended to, they have to be guarded against all kinds of greedy corporate use, and they have to be guarded from abuse, and that's what public access is. It's a kind of an electronic park, and that we need to conserve, just like we try to conserve the national forest lands and the national parks, as one area in the land that is taken care of for the community and to be used by the community. That's what public access channels are to the airwaves.
Access now.
Community-based organization utilized public access and for its community, and it was able to develop not only projects that involved that were issue-oriented, but also more artistic projects that would help the youth as well as the regular community, the older population, find some way of expressing themselves. And also find a way of just understanding each other across generational lines. And so that's just another way that public access can be utilized.
I also speak as an employee of Rise and Shine Productions, which is a nonprofit organization that works in the public high schools here in New York using video to improve the quality of education for so-called at-risk students who may have little other incentive to stay in school. Video gives these young people a voice in which to speak out on issues affecting them. Issues such as racism, teen pregnancy, and safe sex, to name just a few. A real public access facility would be a place where New York could allow its young people to speak out and be involved in this city's issues, as well as encourage young artists to produce and exhibit their own work.
All it takes is six pedal back classes, or about 3 hours, and three editing classes, and you can put your own TV show on. You don't have that here in New York. There's a different contract. We're one city. Everybody should have the same privileges as we have in Queens.
Last night, some of my friends and me were sitting around watching my TV. 13 channels, but nothing could we see that reflected our collective reality. So I got up knowing that I was able to get a public access station. On the cable on the station was this message, and we could not excuse it if you don't want to lose it. You've got to use it. Access is the place where the public has a space to make programs that show our diversity. But action is taking and policy making, 'cause the city needs a free access facility. The this proclamation confirmed our suspicion. Manhattan has a public access coalition. Fight for the franchise so nobody can refuse it. Cause if you don't wanna lose it, you've got to use it. If you don't wanna lose it, you've got to use it. If you don't wanna lose it, you've got to use it.
Don't just watch TV, make it! Support Access Now!
Okay. Give it a shot. Maybe I would do something kooky, like a soap opera, you know, a surrealistic soap opera.
I think it would be about the diseases that are on today, you know, AIDS, and make people more aware, you know, educate them more about it. That's what I would do if I had to do a show of some kind.
Anything that's good for the senior citizens. Anything that would, you know, seniors, well, that's good for the senior citizens, that's good for the children.
School stuff. Guys!
Oh, that would be marvelous. Oh, I would put on, I'd show this neighborhood in all its beauty and all its glory. The beautiful children and the beautiful people all around here.
Me?
Yeah.
Cooking show, health and nutrition.
Thank you.
I'd like to see more gay and lesbian issue shows. I don't think there's enough of those.
I think television is the greatest medium for healing and positivity that there is. I think that the way you can reach the race consciousness of the human race is through television. It's actually ordained by God.